We've been talking about the clues to our purpose. And we've talked about so many different things that I think I'm going to create some kind of a spreadsheet where we can score ourselves on the various personality traits and character traits and core values and beliefs and perspective, worldview, and all these different things that make us unique. Today, I think what we need to talk about is how the tough times that we've gone through influence us and change us. And we automatically think, yeah, this horrible thing that I went through changed me. And we automatically go to in a bad way, mm-hmm. changed us in a negative way, broke us down, broke us in half, wounded us so badly that we can't recover from it. I want to say, yes, these horrible things that have happened to us, and we've all experienced pain of one kind or another. And whatever it is, it's painful to us. So let's dispense with that notion of comparing our painful events or trying to dismiss and say, well, what I went through was not nearly what you went through or whatever. It's pain is pain, and we've all gone through it. And it does change us, but not entirely in a bad way. Mm-hmm. Our painful experiences develop in us character traits that you really can't get any other way.
Right.
Like courage, resilience, resourcefulness, tenacity, determination. All of these character traits are so incredibly powerful and highly valuable in the workplace and in relationships. And I mean, you name it. Okay. It also, tough times develop in us certain skills, survival skills. You learn survival skills by surviving. And so there are certain skills and abilities that we pick up in order to survive that are exactly what we need to fulfill our purpose. Okay, so I'm going on and on, Jenny, and I want to hear from you. What do you think about all this?
Well, it's interesting, Rhonda, because I think that we all know, everybody that's listening knows that, like you said, we've all experienced tough times at different places of our lives. I mean, it starts when we're kids and, you know, being left out. I mean, from the things that are just natural in childhood, there's other things that are more severe that people have experienced. You know, they have life stories that are extremely full of all kinds of trauma and things. But the point of that is that it starts when we're young and it goes through the rest of our lives. I mean, because we live in a world that's full of sin and there's corruption and all these things, this is not our home, particularly for those who are Christ followers. And we know we're only going to be here for a certain amount of time. But we cannot avoid the tough times. I mean, thankfully, we don't know when they're coming. And sometimes we can anticipate it, but we don't always know when we're going to have a tough time or a situation with someone or a situation that we're in at work or whatever is going to turn to a trial, turn to a tough time. So the first thing I think we need to know is that no one is exempt and no one gets to avoid having tough times. Mm-hmm. And I think what you said is the character traits and the skills that we develop are so amazing in some ways once we get past a certain point of the trial. And so we might be in one right now and we might be headed for one. I heard a pastor say recently, if you're not having trouble, you will in the near future. I mean, something's coming at us. I mean, it could be a nail in our tire and we can't get to a job interview. But the fact is, it's not something that we want to be scared of, but that we recognize happens to everyone. And so I think one of the keys is when we're having a tough time, what do we do when we're having a tough time? Because we don't see those character traits yet. We don't see those skills yet. So I think we need to stop for a minute and think about what do we do when we're going through a tough time? And I think the things that we need to do are, one, if we have a trusted person to help us through, if we need some help of some kind, I think that's important. And what we're really talking about is that tough times do bring us these things. But when we're going through it, it's hard to see. So what I've learned to do in my life, because I've been through some tough times, I didn't go back and look at the tough times specifically and spend time there, but I looked back and thought, what did I learn in that tough time? What did I gain? What did I put in my knapsack that I'm carrying through life? What did I gain in that time? So a couple of things that stick out for me is I gained great strength from going through tough times. And I don't know a lot of people that haven't. And tough times and adversity is a great teacher. It really is. And so when you're going through a tough time, look back and go, did I make it through that one? Yes, I did. Am I going to make it through this one? Yes, I am. Yes. And then go, you know what? This is something that I know I drew from that. So I'm thinking of some tough times I've had. And one of the things I thought of was I've gained a whole lot of strength from my tough times. And so those are beautiful nuggets that we go, okay, I'm going to get even stronger when I go through this one. So I think we need to reflect. And again, we talk a lot about that, camping back at old things and things like that. We need to process them. We need to move through them and pass them with a strengthened spirit, with a more perseverant spirit, so that we can go to the next thing that's coming toward us.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, I love that you said that, Jenny, because, you know, the whole idea of talking about hard things that we've been through, I know there was a time in my life when I would have said, yeah, I'm skipping that podcast episode. I don't want to think about it. I had to live through it one time. So that was plenty. And I don't want to dredge it back up. I don't want to talk about it. I just want to try to forget it ever happened. But what I know that God says in his word in Romans 8:28, you know me, I can't quote a lot of scriptures, but Romans 8:28 is, it's just branded in my brain. And my whole life really is about Romans 8:28, that God works together for good, all the things that have happened to us. And there's a condition in there. And the Rhonda paraphrase version is, you know, when we'll cooperate and collaborate with him, he works it all together for good. So it just doesn't work to bury it. Mm-hmm. So rather than bury it, the way we can cooperate and collaborate with God is to say, okay, I'm going to bring this out in the light of day, and I'm going to look at it at the age and maturity that I have now, so that now you have an adult perspective.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So if we think about this, so if somebody's listening and something happened when they were 7 years old, think about it. You have the perspective of the words that were said or the actions that took place, whatever it was that happened, your perspective is that of a 7 year old, because that's how old you were when it happened. Mm-hmm. If it happened when you were little bitty toddler, before you could really speak, and you don't even have words to explain it or describe it or say what happened, that's considered a primal wound. And your perspective is primal because you can't even put words to it. So whatever it was that happened, whenever it happened, and maybe it's a bunch of things, maybe it's not one thing, maybe it's a lifetime of things, we have to remember that in taking it out and looking at it in the light of day right now, we sort of have to set aside the perspective and conclusions and opinions that we have about it and look at it more like a reporter, an investigative reporter looking for just the facts. Because we can't let the perspective and opinions and feelings of the seven-year-old, to continue with that example, influence the review of the situation today. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Because it could be that, you know, something was said or done that was super hurtful, but you look at it now and think, oh my gosh, I've said those exact same words, not intending anybody any harm, but you're in a hurry, or you don't feel well, or you're completely stressed out, or it was the wrong timing. You know, somebody hits you as you're, you know, coming in the door from a hard day at work, whatever it is. But if we can set those feelings aside and look at it objectively, and sometimes it helps to do this with a trusted friend, or think of the story as somebody's coming to you and telling you the story as though it happened to them, and you're the adult saying, okay, well, you know, let's give that person the benefit of the doubt, or let's look at, was the person who said these hurtful words, maybe was the person out of their right mind? Mm-hmm. Are there mental health issues? Is there drug misuse or whatever? But looking at all that is really important. And, you know, back to what you said about pulling it out and not staying there, we're not going to stay here forever.
Yeah.
looking at it in this light of this day, we can pull out, just like you did, saying, you know, I realize this stuff made me stronger. Well, you know what, Jenny? I used to think that all the things that happened to me made me, it's kind of an old phrase now, but people used to say it when I was growing up, damaged goods. Mm-hmm. And I had that in my mind as being too broken to be fixed. That I would never be fixed. Like this is how I am. Well, I saw that as a bad thing. This is how I am, and it's not good. So if somebody 40 years ago would have said to me, God has a good purpose for your life, I would have thought, this is nonsense. Only I wouldn't have used the word nonsense. So I now understand that all these things that I thought broke me and that I couldn't be fixed actually prepared me for my purpose, for what God had for me. Yes, I am too strong-willed and I'm too loud and I have really strong opinions and I blurt out the wrong thing at the wrong time. And I could go on and on about all the things that are wrong about me. But in the years that I was a national child advocate and I would go to Washington, D.C. and meet with legislators and staffers about child welfare issues, it really helped that I had this strong, deep, booming voice and that I was passionate and loud about what I was there to talk about, protecting children who have been abused. And it just turns out that everything I thought was wrong with me is really what's right about me. It's just not right in every situation. Like Jenny, I couldn't have been a librarian. God didn't make me to do that. I have another thing that I was made to do. And so when we realize, when we go through this process of looking at our hard times, really thinking about it, how did it change us? What character traits did it develop in us? And then we say, okay, we write down those character traits. Like, I'm trying to think of some of mine, persistent, tenacious, okay? We realize, oh my gosh, all the times that somebody has said, oh, Rhonda, you're such a nag. You go on and on and on. Okay, guess what? That's tenacity. That's persistence. There's a place for it mm-hmm. in the world. It's needed in the world, not in every single situation. Right. Right? But so we all have these things that are developed in us that are such strong clues to what we were made to do. There's a place where when we plug in all of these things that we have, that we know because, not because we learned it in a book, not because we went to school, not because we watched it in a movie or whatever, but because we lived it. Mm-hmm. When we think of those things that we got that changed us because we lived them, those are the things that are foundational to our purpose. Mm-hmm.
So well said, Rhonda. I loved it. And you know, one of the things that you said that I think is so important is our perspective. So when we're looking at a tough time, are we looking at the tough time? Are we looking at what people have said about us? You know, that makes it difficult. You know, Rhonda, you're this. Jenny, you're too squirrely. Jenny, you know, whatever it is. Or are we looking at the perspective of what we can learn and extract and take from it as it relates to our future? Because really, it's kind of like a prism. You know, there's the perspective of the situation. You know, the person that hurt us, the how physically hurt we were. It was an accident or something. Is that what our perspective is? Or what other people have said? Or can our perspective be, what are the things and the character traits, like you just said? When someone says, Rhonda, it's this, and you're saying, no, it's tenacity. That is a perspective shift. That's a mindset shift. And, you know, the mindset stuff can get a little extreme and all that stuff. But the point is we have to have a perspective of, can I and will I embrace what I can learn from a tough time?
Oh, Jenny, I'm telling you, I don't know how many times in these podcasts I go, oh, Jenny, that's perfect. That's why God brought us together, because you stated it so well. If if you're listening here today and you're saying, nah, that's not for me, that's not me, there's no possible good that could ever come from this, listen, I get it. But you will never, ever get the lesson. You will never know what good can come from it until you literally, intentionally shift your mindset over to, okay, doggone it, I had to live through it. I am going to find some nugget of gold out of this. I am going to mine this for everything it's worth. And if it's just one nugget of gold I get out of it, I'm doing that. Because whatever happened to you already happened. You can't go back and change it. You can't continue to suffer from it. Because, you know, let's say something was intentionally done. I mean, like in my case, my mother left, never came back. I was abused by caregivers. When something is ill-intentioned, harm was intended. Don't you dare give that person who harmed you another minute of your life. Ever. I'm not going to give anybody the satisfaction of knowing that they've hurt me. It's bad enough if they did hurt me to begin with. I'm not going to let it go longer. I mean, I'll give myself, oh, I don't know, like a good 5 minutes to feel really sorry for myself. And then move on. Because I'm just not giving any of this precious time in this life away to anybody else. Because the reality is, Jenny, you've said this so many times before, there's somebody in the world who needs what you have, who needs who you are. So as long as we're sitting over here feeling sorry for ourselves or just continuing to live in that past that's no longer happening, then the person or people over here in your future who need you, who need what you know. They need, maybe it's somebody who's going through exactly what you've been through. And you can look at them and say, you can do this. I did it. I'm still standing. And you will be too. You're going to make it too. And maybe it's a more practical thing of, here's how I made it through. I kept myself busy. I did this. I did, you know, whatever that you did to get through that super painful time. You can share that with other people who are where you used to be.
Right. Because that can be part of your purpose, you know, and that's why we do these Rhonda, these podcasts, because we want to lead people and just walk with people down the road, encourage people. We may never meet you, but we want to encourage you down the road because you've been walking a road with tough times, but we have to keep walking. We can't stop walking. And once we change our perspective and we see the character traits and skills that have come, we're going to be moving toward our purpose. Like you said it earlier, a few minutes ago, I love it because I know the strength or the perseverance or the character traits and skills I gained have everything to do with my purpose.
Yes. Because
I put this great recipe together, but he also knows everything that we're going to go through. Okay. Every trial, every tribulation, every issue, but we all have breath in our lungs to keep going and to live out that purpose. And while we do, we can't let these tough times paralyze us. But we need to let the tough times be part of what drives us to the purpose.
Ooh, that's so good. I always say, if we're still breathing, we're still in the game.
Right.
We still have a purpose. I don't care what you've been through, how old you are. You know, it doesn't work to say to me, oh, my time is past. I'm too old now. Or don't say, I don't have the right education. Oh, heck yeah, you do. You live through it. Maybe you have the graduate degree in the Hard Knocks University. You know, don't say I'm from the wrong place. I'm, you know, or I didn't get the education. Whatever it is that you think is wrong or you think is the thing that's holding you back from finding and living your purpose. No, it's not. And if you want to talk about that, if you want to come on and dispute that with us, we invite you to. There's a link in the podcast. Message us and we'll absolutely talk about it. But I think we're going to win. I think we're going to win the debate. And I really want you to come at this with an open mind. In fact, I'm looking at my Find Your Purpose stuff. And I think I'm going to do a free download, Jenny, of this, of the worksheet that we have that's the character traits acquired or developed in adversity. Because I think it's important to give people more examples mm-hmm. of the kinds of, there's a, you know, probably a zillion, we couldn't name them all, but pretty typical character traits that come out of hard times. Probably the number one thing, I'm not sure it's a character trait, but yeah, maybe it is empathy.
Yeah.
When we go through something personally, it tenderizes our hearts for somebody else who's going through that same thing. You yeah. see this with, I mean, there are so many different groups, you name it, there's a group for it. People who have been victims of violent crime, there's a support group. People who have lost a loved one, support group. People who have lived through cancer, support group. Think of that. There are people out there who you can help, and they can help you too. So I'm not saying that we should, you know, be completely invested in continually rehashing, you know, the bad things that we've been through. But once we've done that and we've mined those nuggets of gold, sharing them is the whole point. And it reminds me, Jenny, of what we talked about in the last episode about how our purpose is really always about the unique ways that we can help others. Mm-hmm. And the empathy and all these other character traits, they equip us to help other people.
Yep. And I always say it, Rhonda, the world is waiting for what you have.
Absolutely. Well, that's a good place for us to end, Jenny. And so I'm going to do that. I want to encourage you to please, please subscribe. Give us a rating. When you give us a rating, it elevates us on the standings of podcasts so that other people might see the podcast. And please share it with anybody who you think can be helped by this. Anybody who is unhappy, doesn't like their life, hates their job, you know, whatever situation that they're in, they're just not living joyfully. Please share this. And we'd love to hear from you. So we'll see you again next week.